All right, North America Racing League GT3 M Division. We are at the Red Bull Ring for this lovely race number four. And I qualified P32 in a 42-car grid with a 131.7, which is 1.7 seconds off the pole. So a nice compact grid as per usual. I'm bringing up the back end of it, or close enough. We'll see how I do. I'm fairly consistent here with this setup. It's a high downforce setup, and it's a 106 degree track right now. And so I was pretty consistent in the low 132s and in my practice laps. I wasn't punching too far out of that, and I wasn't falling too far behind that. So if I can drive a nice consistent race, who knows, maybe I can make up some ground like I have in the last couple of races. I'm not expecting to do anything fantastic on pace alone. So we'll see how we do. Thank you for joining me, and if you do like this sort of racing or you enjoy this race in particular, please do click on like. If you're not a subscriber and you like this sort of thing, please subscribe. You'll be notified of new races as they get launched on the YouTube platform. And of course, if you see me doing something that you want to make fun of, or you just want to give me some encouragement, feel free to give me a comment. Love comments, and we'll kind of enjoy the race together. I am not doing this live because anytime I try to live stream, it breaks my computer. So I record them.
42, 40 minutes.
If you ask me questions, I'll either answer them in the chat or comments section of the video, or if it's really interesting,
car number 159 in the left column.
I'll try to answer it in the next stream. So let's see how we do. Away we go. Parade lap.
Catch up to car number 159. Okay, Chip, be ready.
Here we go.
Green, green, green. Yellow flag.
Amen. I think I got tapped from behind, but only because I had to keep from tapping the guy in front of me. You go, boy. Alrighty, you must have gotten a slowdown. Don't you feel silly? Guys are killing me. No idea how badly damaged I am. One sale that left. So it must not be too badly damaged. That was a creamy exit. Thank you.
nice and smooth. Don't overdrive the car. B25.
I'll probably shift down to second there, but I don't know. Must have cut that inside a little too much. A little 1x action going on.
Flag.
think he must be broken. Left your room, dude. Shitty. Thank you. Damn it. Block me from pitting, you fucking asshole.
Your speed. Your lane speed limit is 50 miles per hour. 300 feet. 100 feet. Traffic behind. Watch your mirrors.
Hello, boys.
two dots. Ahead is now 1.6 seconds. P23. Okay, Jim. 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left. To go. White flag, one more lap. One gallon remaining. Come on, Chip. Push, push, push. We can catch this car. And there's the finish. Good result, mate. Well done.
Oof. All right, that was a race. I'm still sweating. That was just crazy. Partially because it's hot in here, but it was a lot of work. Some excitement there right down to the very end. I didn't think I was going to get a position back, but I don't know if it's a lapped car or a wrecked car, what it was, kind of bottled up there on the right-hand side, and it made for an opportunity to use it as a pick. And hey, man, it was the last lap, man. I was going to go for it. So not bad. Pretty exciting. At the front, of course, looks like David Hicks came away with the win. A fast lap of 1:30.261. And on that hot of a track, man, it was that was moving. Rob Rodriguez Jr. Came away with P2. So congratulations to him. And Will Coffey made good on getting a podium again tonight. He was somebody that was commenting in the Discord channel that, you know, he was going to make a run for the front. So that was awesome. He started P2 and lost a position during the race, but the podium was pretty much how they started, except 2 and 3 reversed their order. So good race by those guys, and mad respect, man, to be able to put down laps down in the 130s on a track that hot with a high downforce configuration is pretty darn stout. I started in P32, and it looks like I finished in P20 according to this chart, although at the end of the race it said I was in P21. I'll have to dig into that and figure out if maybe somebody got disqualified or disconnected early or what happened there. But that's not a bad run. Last two races I managed to finish in 19th, so to finish in 20th is not so bad. Coming into this race, according to the unofficial stats, I was in 22nd in the series after the first three races. So that was with, I think, a really deep finish the first race at Road Atlanta because of an incident, and then two 19th place finishes. Now P20, I should move up a little bit further, maybe stay in 22nd, maybe move up to 21st. I hope, maybe not. We'll see. But not bad with this group. Again, I keep saying this is a good group of guys, really, really fast, good pace. Impressive racers. You saw a close racing there at the end. Everybody was given mad respect, mad room, that makes for great racing. I'm looking forward to watching the broadcast now. So again, if you like this sort of racing or you like this particular one, please click on like. If you want to see more of what I do, I do this with North America Racing League. I do PCA Sim Racing, and I do some iRacing official stuff here and there. Also do Champion Motorsports in their iRacing Endurance, Team Endurance series. So if any of that sounds like it's fun to watch, go on ahead and subscribe to the channel and you'll get notified when I release new videos. And of course, I do love comments, so feel free to comment on anything you saw. I know that I'm doing all sorts of wrong on this track. If you want to give me some suggestions, hey, I'll listen to them. Sure, why not? But thank you very much for watching. I appreciate your time. And as always, take care of yourselves. Spaß machen im Sport.